They say spirits or troubled souls. You know,
they are the committed people who committed suicide. Those terrorized souls, they will see, it is, you can't even call them soul. It is like a broken chaotic mirror on which the slight reflection also falls, because the reflection is universal. So what happens to that broken pieces of mirrors? It is so restless, it tries to jump here and there, but it is not powerful enough to enter into our body and harm us, because we already have a soul. One body cannot have two soul, so they cannot harm you. They can only be seen by you. You get frightened and be harmed. You harm yourself. They themselves have no power to harm you. Because ghosts have no powers to harm you. That is what I am talking now. Because you have 7 layers of you. Let me describe the layers. The body made out of bone, flesh, this. This is the first layer. Second layer is your breathing structure. Your breathing structure, which has a 5 action. Inhaling, holding, spreading, exhaling, cleaning. 5 action. This breathing infrastructure is called second layer. Your thinking infrastructure, that is third layer. Your feeling infrastructure, emotions, that is fourth layer. The deep sleep time, what you experience, the rejuvenation infrastructure, like a refuel station, that fueling station, that is the fifth layer. And the bliss, joy you experience once in a while in your life, the completion, that is the sixth layer. And the soul reflection is the seventh layer. You have 7 layers now, but that terrorized soul will have only 3 layer. The soul reflection, completion layer, and the rejuvenation layer. It will not have the emotion infrastructure, the thinking infrastructure, breathing infrastructure, and 5 senses body infrastructure. When it has 4 layer less, it is less powerful than you, it cannot harm you. It can be seen by you, perceived by you, it can be your servant, but it cannot harm you. For example, if I tell a ghost, take this water bottle and keep it there, he can do it, but he cannot harm me. For any human being, he cannot harm. Even if I tell, go and harm that person, he cannot harm you. He can appear in front of you, that you can get frightened. But he himself cannot torture you or give you suffering. Because he is a less powerful species. He is not more powerful species than you. That is why all the black magic, sending the ghosts, all this negative energy thing, they can only appear in front of you in the terrorizing form. If you just laugh at them, they can't do anything. They cannot touch you. They cannot disturb you. But seeing the form, you get shaken, frightened, have a heart attack, is all your stupidity. By law, they cannot touch you. And by the natural flow of life, they will not be able to harm you. They cannot enter your body, like how the movies are showing. They cannot snatch away something from you, or they can't even touch you, because you are a higher species than them. It is like a tree. Tree cannot come and beat you. Understand? Because yes, he does not have many powers you have. You also breathe, he also breathes. But if you run away, he cannot chase you. Many powers you have, he doesn't have. Same way, he cannot even fall on you and kill you. Only if the wind comes, he can fall. That is not out of his will. Beyond his will only he falls. Same way, a ghost is a lower level species. He cannot harm you. He cannot do anything to you. He can only be seen by you. He can only maximum request you for a help. The ghost maximum help you can do is giving them the Shraddha in some energy centers like Badri, Bodh Gaya or a master's stomach. The food you offer to him, offer to master, directly goes as a Shraddha, Pinda Darpana, to the ghosts and they feel they are liberated. They are given the smooth waiting lounge or the smooth passover to the next body. If your family ghosts come, the only help they can ask you is, they can ask you to give Pinda Darpana. If you give a food to enlightened master, or food, the Shraddha in Brahma Kapala, so those kind of you help you can do to them. Other than that, you also can't help them in any way. They also can't harm you in any way. That much only is the maximum help they can ask you. If you feel your parents or relatives, your family members, ghost is present in your house, you are seeing them once in a while, or somebody is seeing them, you don't need to be afraid. They may be just begging you for a help to liberate them, to give Shraddha for them, to give Pinda Darpana for them. That's all, nothing else.